What is the shortest length path for a car that can go forwards and backwards? Like most of life, the answer is it depends. Sometimes you can drive straight to the goal. Sometimes you need to change direction. There are setups where the shortest path is a three-point turn. This demonstration computes the shortest length path for a car with a forward and a reverse gear and a minimum turning radius Rmin. You can play with it online or download the code yourself. I'll show you how to code this later in the video. The progress slider moves the blue car along the route from green to red. Use the locators to change the start and goal positions and orientations. A car with a reverse gear is often called a Reed's-Shep car, while a car that only has a forward gear is often called a Dubin's car, in honor of the mathematicians who first studied these problems. You can see that sometimes the paths are quite different, since the Dubin solutions are a subset of the Reed's-Shep solutions. This demonstration uses a simplified mathematical model of a car that moves in the XY plane. The car is specified by the XY location of the center of the car's rear axle and the orientation theta of the car. The car cannot move sideways because the rear wheels would have to slide instead of roll. The car model stipulates that the car has a maximum steering angle that translates into a minimum turning radius Rmin. The minimum turning radius circles are drawn tangent to the curved sections of the path with thin gray circles. The shortest path depends on the turning radius. The system equations with velocity v are dx is equal to v cosine of theta, the change in y is equal to v times the sine of theta, and the change in theta is equal to the steering input u, which is limited to the set negative 1 over Rmin to 1 over Rmin. We assume that v is always either positive 1 or negative 1. The task is to minimize the length of the curve traced out by the center of the rear axle as it moves from the start to the goal. That path is the bounded curvature shortest path given by this integral. Back in 1990, Reed's and Shep proved that the shortest path consists of no more than 5 segments, where in each segment u is either negative 1 over Rmin, 0, or 1 over Rmin, which means the car is always either turning hard left, going straight, or turning hard right, and the car is moving either forwards or backwards. The optimal path is one of 48 different path types. Here is a cool fact. The Reed's-Shep path can be used as a metric for the XY theta configuration of a car because the distance does not change if you swap the start and the goal positions. The distance is only 0 if the start and goal are equivalent, and it obeys the triangle inequality. You might remember that the Dubin's car has only 6 possible path types. Because the car can only move forwards, the Dubin's path is never shorter than the Reed-Shep path. The Dubin's path is not a metric. Often, the distance changes if the start and goal positions are swapped. Our Reed-Shep implementation is based on the Python code by Nathan Leichel. The key thing I want to point out is that the code isn't hard to convert to your favorite language. We calculate all 48 paths, compute their lengths, and then pick the shortest. This isn't time-consuming because there are closed-form equations for all path types. Also, there are really just 12 path types that we then either time-reverse using the function time-flip or mirror using the function reflect. We then throw out any solutions that are empty or that are marked as invalid. To simplify, we use the reference frame of the green car, and the relative displacement is x, y, phi. We also divide the distances by Rmin, so we can solve in a reference frame where all the turns have radius 1. Let's take a look at the first function. Path type 1 is a CSC path, which means curve straight curve, where both C's are in the same direction. We simply convert an offset position from Cartesian coordinates to polar coordinates, and then find the shortest angle. Path 2 is a curve straight curve where the C's are in different directions. Again, we convert an offset position from Cartesian coordinates to polar coordinates, and then compute the angles and distances. Path 3 is 3 C's, but we switch from forward to reverse gear each step. We show the gear switch with a vertical line. Again, there is a conversion from Cartesian to polar coordinates and a few simple trig calculations. Path 4 is a curve, followed by a switch of forward gear, followed by two curves in opposite directions. You can see the conversion from Cartesian to polar coordinates and a few simple trig calculations. The function mod pi returns the input angle wrapped to be between negative pi and pi. Path 5 is two curves in opposite directions, followed by a gear shift and then another curve. It's very similar to path 4, with a conversion and trig. Path 6 is two curves in opposite directions, a gear shift, followed by two curves in opposite directions. Note that the second and third curves have the same values, here called CU. Here is a Cartesian to polar conversion and the trig. Path 7 is a curve, a gear switch, two curves the same length but opposite directions, a gear switch, and another curve. This is the longest code. It doesn't exist if the distance is not between 0 and 6. Path 8 is a curve, gear switch, curve of 90 degrees, straight, and then another curve. Whew! It is computed with four trig operations in a Cartesian to polar conversion. Path 9 is a curve, straight, curve of 90 degrees, gear shift, curve. Path 9 also has four trig operations and a Cartesian to polar conversion. Path 10 is a curve, gear shift, curve of 90 degrees, straight, curve. Only two trig operations and a Cartesian to polar conversion. Path 11 is curve, straight, curve of 90 degrees, gear shift, curve. This also has only two trig operations and a Cartesian to polar conversion. Finally, path 12 is a five-segment path. Curve, gear shift, curve 90 degrees, straight, curve 90 degrees, gear shift, curve. It sounds complicated, but only three trig operations and a Cartesian to polar conversion. This one only exists if the distance is greater than 4. Again, we do all 12 of these path types forward and backward in time, and then both mirrored to get 48 paths. With the Dubin's car, sometimes short distances require longer paths than long distances. For the Reed-Shep car, the path length always decreases as the distance decreases. It is also easy to concatenate Reed-Shep paths together. These properties make it easy to use the Reed-Shep path for motion planning. We call this system small-time locally controllable. Suppose you want to move the car from this start to this goal, but without hitting anything. If doing the Reed-Shep path directly fails, you can draw a path for a holonomic vehicle. That means it has no constraints on moving sideways. Then you subdivide this path as often as needed to get a path to the goal that doesn't collide. Enjoy playing with the demo, available at demonstrations.wolfram.com/shortest path for forward and reverse motions of a car. Let me know what you think.